Bonjour, welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad to see you today for another perfume review video. And today we are going to talk about what type of perfume French women wear, what type of perfume do we like, what type of perfume we don't like, how we apply perfume, what is our beauty routine about perfume. You're gonna know everything about, you know, French girl perfume in this video. I'm going to show you, you know, my perfume collection, the perfume French woman also used to wear every day at night. So in this video, you're gonna master pretty much, you know, French girl perfume. So if you like this video also, don't forget to subscribe and let's start. French girl, you know, French people in general, they just love perfume. Perfume is really into our culture. The first perfume were Italian, French also. So perfume is really a big thing here in France. It's really into our culture. But I'm gonna say it's even more than just an accessorize. It's really into our beauty routine, okay? It's part of our routine. I know French women who don't wear a lot of makeup, they don't wear makeup at all, but they apply perfume. So just to show you that it's super, super important in France, especially for French girl, French woman. And just to also to explain to you, I wasn't allowed to wear makeup even at high school, but I was allowed to apply perfume. So just an indication that really, you know, for French girl, perfume is really, really even more important than wearing makeup or, you know, just wearing a bag, a nice bag. You know, perfume is really into our beauty routine. So it's really into our beauty routine. And usually we apply perfume after shower or after you dressing up. You have like two different type. Personally, I like to wear my perfume after my shower because I think usually the perfume is more long lasting. Also, it's more intimate because for me, you know, perfume has to be wear. They really need to be wear on the skin. Perfume has made when people create the perfume, when the nose create the perfume, they really, really test the perfume on the skin. And perfume has to be wear on the skin first, more than, you know, into the clothes. But I also like to spray sometimes perfume just after dressing up and you just before going out. Also, it's a different thing. So just to also to explain to you, you know, our culture, how we see perfume, and it's super, super important. Sometimes we just, you know, we change the perfume depending of our style, depending of our mood. Usually I prepare, you know, my outlook, my outfit for the day. And I also, you know, I also like to accessorize my perfume, to match my perfume with my outfit. I also love to wear signature perfume. French girls have a big thing about signature perfume. You can also watch my video about it. But a signature perfume is really a perfume that define you. If you have one perfume to choose, you will choose this perfume, and this perfume really, really define who you are, define your personality, define your soul, define your identity. Okay, there's just one perfume, and this perfume is you. And I find it very, very beautiful. And French people, French girls, they really have this signature perfume thing. Usually they like to remember people from their perfume. You remember your mother, your grandmother from their perfume. It's really a big, big thing. And there's no one French girl who's not able to say, okay, this is my signature perfume, this is my perfume. They really like to wear perfume for years, to stick to the same perfume that really define who they are. So signature perfume is also a big, big thing for French girls. So as you can see, we love perfume. We like to wear perfume every day. French girls really like to wear perfume every single day. It's really part of their beauty routine. Even more important, I think, than just makeup or accessorize. And it's really into our lifestyle, wearing perfume. So what type of perfume do French women, French girl like? I'm gonna say that French girl don't like to wear very, very loud, super strong perfume. If you ask in the street or even I ask around me, they like to wear very, very subtle perfume or very complex, rich perfume, but not super loud. We think that perfume, you know, very loud perfume, it's a little bit vulgar. And there's also, you know, French woman, French girl, they look very, you know, effortless, chic. It's really our style. But they are very, very sophisticated when it comes to perfume, okay? There's no effortless chic when it comes to perfume. I know French girls, they are super, super picky when they choose the perfume. They like to try different perfume. They like complex, rich, but subtle. Sophisticated perfume, of course, elegant, chic. They also like to stick to some big name, you know, timeless, iconic perfume, Chanel No. 5, for example, Dior. They like big, big name, timeless, iconic and chic perfume. There are three types of perfume, three family of perfume French girls really like or love. The first one is the floral family. And when you think about French perfume, you really think about floral perfume, and the most iconic one with a lot of aldehyde, which is a synthetic flower, is of course Chanel No. 5. But when people think about French perfume, they really think about floral, and they have right, because you know, the most iconic French perfume, they combine a lot of different flowers. And in the floral family, you're gonna find two types of perfume. You're gonna find the white family perfume that really French girl really, really love. And you're gonna find the yellow family perfume, which is a little bit different, with aldehyde, for example. We categorize aldehyde in the yellow flower family. And I'm gonna show some perfume, the most iconic one that French girls really, really love. In the white flowers family, and you know that I'm a big, big fan of white flowers. So white flowers is extremely, extremely chic. And when you think about white flowers, you think about lily of the valley, for example, orchid, a little bit of gardenia, which is not really a white flower, but usually they combine, you know, lily of the valley with gardenia. You think about, of course, lila lily, which is a very beautiful flower. So white flowers perfume are very, very French, in a sense that lily of the valley is really the most French flower ever. So lily of the valley is really the most French flower ever, because for the 1st of May, we usually like to give some lily of the valley bouquet. It's really the symbol of luck. Usually French people think that lily of the valley brings luck. But for example, Dior, you know, Christian Dior used to love lily of the valley, and it was the symbol of Maison Dior for years. It's still the symbol. So lily of the valley, it's really a French flower, and I know a lot of French girls around me who loves lily of the valley, and also they love to wear perfume with lily of the valley. So I have three iconic perfume with me that I can show you with lily of the valley. The first one, and you probably know about this one, it's really the most iconic French perfume, and a lot of people love this one. The first one is Anaïs by Cacharel. So I have a vintage sample. So Anaïs, it's really an iconic perfume for a lot of French girl generation. This is a 70 perfume. My mother used to wear this one, my grandmother also. It's really, really an iconic perfume. And when it was created, this perfume was really, really trendy here in Paris. I think it's a very Parisian perfume, and a lot of Parisian girls used to wear this one. So in type of notes, you're gonna find a lot of white flowers notes. This is a very subtle, very, very subtle perfume with a lot of like lily of the valley, gardenia, jasmine, ylang ylang. It's really, really creamy. There's no oriental in the base. And I think it's really the incarnation or the symbol of French French perfume. This is a very, very delicate perfume. This is a very good perfume for young women, and I know a lot of like young French girls, they love this one, and it's still a very iconic perfume. So just by curiosity, I just want to try a little bit just to tell you a little bit more about the notes, but yeah, it's very, very delicate. So the base has a little bit of musk, but the base is very, very, I'm gonna say, delicate and subtle. So you have really the notes, the opening notes of Lily of the Valley, Jasmine and Orchid. Yeah, it's a very, very delicate, perfume. Okay, so another one of my favorite also white flower perfume is Van Cleef & Arpels Muguet Blanc. So unfortunately, this one is completely discontinued. I don't know why Van Cleef & Arpels decided to stop the production of this one. But this is a very, very luxury perfume. It's from the Extraordinaire collection, so it's haute, I'm gonna say haute parfumerie. I really love Van Cleef & Arpels perfume. I think they are super, super good, and very, very intense perfume, very elegant, very sophisticated and complex. Muguet Blanc is extremely complex perfume. So this one is one of the most elegant, sophisticated perfume I ever smell. It's even more sophisticated than Florissimo by Creed, just to tell you a little bit about this perfume. So you have to know also that Lily of the Valley is extremely complex because you can't distill and extract the flower. So perfumer knows we have to recreate completely, you know, the smell, the perfect smell, this natural smell of Lily of the Valley, and extremely difficult. That's why also Lily of the Valley perfume are a little bit more expensive, little bit more luxurious, I'm gonna say. But Van Cleef & Arpels, this one is very, very, very nice. This is very, like, one of the most pure Lily of the Valley perfume I ever smell. You can also check, for example, Muguet by Cartier, which is also very, very good perfume. You can also check Hermès. They also have a Muguet perfume, extremely also delicate and sophisticated. I don't want to spray because this one is completely discontinued, but this is extremely sophisticated. This is a very pure Lily of the Valley. There's no green notes. They try to recreate, you know, not the opening notes of Lily of the Valley, but this earth, the earth, really le cœur of Lily of the Valley. And the earth of Lily of the Valley is extremely creamy, extremely white, a little bit of sugary on the side, sweetness, but it's extremely delicate. It's a pure Lily of the Valley. For me, this one is extremely delicate. Another iconic Lily of the Valley that you have to check, and this one is also my signature perfume. So if I have to define who I am this perfume. This is really my signature perfume. So it's a perfume I like to wear every day for every occasion. This is really my smell. This is Diorissimo by Dior. So Diorissimo by Dior is a 50 perfume. This perfume has been launched in 1956. And I love this perfume because Lily of the Valley was really the favorite flower of Christian Dior. It was the symbol of Maison Dior. Christian Dior used to wear on him a lot of Lily of the Valley bouquet. He was really, really into Lily of the Valley. And this one is extremely delicate. There's an opening note of jasmine, gardenia, Lily of the Valley, of course, ylang ylang. On the heart of this perfume, you're gonna find a little bit green, green notes also on the side. And on the base, there's a civet notes and a little bit of amber and musk, which gives a lot more intensity of a Lily of the Valley. But I have to say to you that what I love about this perfume is the opening notes. They're not so green that much, There is also Lily of the Valley in the opening notes and in the base, in the middle notes of this perfume. So this is really an intense Lily of the Valley with a little bit of green notes on the side, but it's not on the earth of this perfume. This perfume is extremely intense, but extremely rich, complex. And the Lily of the Valley is also, you know, it's a delice. It's delicious. It's very, very, it's a very, very good perfume. Very elegant, very chic. So in the floral family, you have what I present to you, the white flowers side. And you have what we call the yellow flowers, the other flowers family. And in the yellow flowers, you just don't have only the yellow flowers, you have also all the red flowers, the pink flowers. It's a different kind of bouquet, but we call it, in perfumery, we call it yellow flowers. And I have to show some of my perfume collection and also the most iconic yellow flowers, French yellow flowers. The first one, and of course you know this one, but this is the most iconic French perfume ever, is Chanel No. 5. So Chanel No. 5 is really a French, iconic French perfume, and this perfume is built around what we call aldehyde, which is a yellow flower, but it's not a natural yellow flower. It's completely synthetic. It has been created for Coco Chanel by Ernest Beau, who was the nose of Maison Chanel, and he decided to create a new flower because Coco Chanel was extremely picky. She was very, very, you know, she wanted to create something new in perfume, and she didn't want to use, you know, the natural flower. She didn't want to use rose. She really, really wanted to create something new, and Ernest Beau decided to build this perfume not around rose but around aldehyde. And it's a very soapy aldehyde. It's a very, very soapy note, soapy fragrance. You're gonna find a lot of aldehyde in different French perfumes. For example, Dior with Maison Dior, which is another perfume also built around aldehyde. With also different type of flowers, you're gonna find rose, jasmine, and aldehyde, but aldehyde is very present. And it's a very soapy vintage, fresh soapy vintage notes, which I really also like, you know, I really like it. It's very elegant. Another also type of perfume, so there's no aldehyde in this one, but there's different kind of yellow flowers. There's rose, gardenia, peach, a little bit of peach. It's not a flower, but there's sugary notes. I love Boucheron perfume, you know, they're very, very good French perfume. So I just bought a Place Vendôme by Boucheron. Very, very nice, you know, perfume. I really like also the bottle. So Place Vendôme, it's one of the most iconic places ever in Paris, very luxury. And this perfume, it's a very, very good French perfume with different kind of, you know, flowers, a lot of rose, jasmine, I smell jasmine, rose, a little bit of peach, apricot also. Ylang Ylang. I love this perfume. This is really a French, you know, French scent. Very, I'm going to say, very characteristic of the French Parisian perfume. Another one also that French girl loves, and I love the bottle, you know, it's Miss Dior Eau de Parfum. So Miss Dior was really an iconic perfume. It was launched in the 50s, and they decided to launch different version of Miss Dior. So you have the original version with a lot of aldehyde, you know, this soapy smell. And you have this one, they launched this one. It's a different version with a lot of rose, jasmine, gardenia, ylang ylang, and with a lot of sugary notes. This one is a very, very sweet, sweet perfume, if I remind me. Yeah, it's very, very sweet, very sweet. It's a sweet floral perfume, but it's very, you know, it's very, very French. So there's a lot of rose. There's rose in the opening note, in the middle, and in the base of this perfume. And with a lot of sweetness in the earth also. So look at the bottle with the little, you know, little bow like that. It's very cute. It's a very French perfume. So another type of perfume that French girls really love, it's also what we call the oriental perfume. And believe me or not, the best oriental perfume are French, and a lot of oriental perfume, they have been also created by French people. But French girls, they don't like loud or very, very strong oriental perfume. They like sophisticated and elegant. So I have, you know, a lot of iconic oriental perfume to show you. And French girls, they like, you know, they like oriental perfume built around amber, rose. Rose is a very, very oriental, oriental fragrance, oriental notes. They also like a little bit of sweet, sugary on the earth. But oriental perfume, it's really a French, I'm gonna say, a French, French fragrance. So the first one I'm gonna show you, which is also an iconic oriental, is Coco Chanel Eau de Parfum. So this one is very, I'm gonna say it's a very intense oriental, but it's an iconic one. It's the oriental version of Coco Chanel, of course. You know, the number five is really built around aldehyde, etc. This one, it's a very intense. There's a little bit of aldehyde in this one, but more built more around a lot of amber, rose amber. If I musk sandalwood, I smell the sandalwood. There's also a lot of woody notes on the base, which gives a very intense, you know, intense, more intensity to this perfume. But it's a very elegant oriental, and I like to wear this one time to time when I go out. This is a beautiful night perfume. Another iconic oriental that you probably know about this one is Shalimar by Guerlain, which is also one of the most iconic oriental. So this is very different compared to Coco Chanel I just saw you. Yeah, it's very, very subtle. It's a very subtle oriental, very soft, okay? So it's for someone who likes soft oriental, not strong, not intense. There's a lot of, you know, there's a little bit of amber, musk, and a lot of vanilla. This one, it's, you know, vanilla, it's very, very present on this one. I smell a little bit of rose, because rose was really the favorite flower of Guerlain. He liked to use Guerlain perfume. There's a lot of Bulgarian rose on the into their perfume. But yeah, it's very, you know, the vanilla is very, very present combined with the rose. But it's a very elegant, I'm gonna say, very elegant oriental. Two over iconic for me, they are really, really iconic oriental perfume. This one by Boucheron. So if you already follow my channel, you know that I love this perfume, Boucheron. It's a very, very complex, sophisticated perfume. Very, very sophisticated. There is a lot of, you know, I smell Lily of the Valley. I think there's Lily of the Valley into this one, but I smell jasmine. I smell ylang ylang. I smell a lot of vanilla, so there's a lot of vanilla into this perfume. Civet on the base, musk, sandalwood. There's no really woody notes. It's a very floral, oriental perfume. But this one, it's a very, very sophisticated perfume. It's one of the best oriental perfume I ever smell. I really love this perfume. You know how much I love this perfume. And you can see, I like to wear this one. I like to wear this one on special occasion when I go out on a date, on a rendezvous. It's a very sophisticated perfume, and I love this one. Another, you know, perfume I really like, and it's also one of the most elegant oriental perfume I like. It's called Nuit Indienne by Jean-Louis Scherrer. I love Jean-Louis Scherrer perfume. You know, Jean-Louis Scherrer was a French designer in the 70s, 80s. He was one of the best French, you know, French designer at that time. He used to design a lot of dresses for Middle East wealthy American woman too. And he has a very beautiful, beautiful perfume collection. And unfortunately, I don't know why it's very underrated, but it's a very niche collection and I love it. There's also, I know also some of my friends, they also love Jean-Louis Scherrer perfume because not everyone is wearing Jean-Louis Scherrer. So we like to wear, you know, French girls, they also like to wear perfume, but you know, niche perfume, raw perfume, perfume that don't, that not everybody is wearing, okay? We like unique things. And Jean-Louis Scherrer perfume are very, very elegant, very rich. So this is a beautiful, beautiful oriental. So it's called Indian Nights. So you can also picture the atmosphere. So there's a lot of civet, sandalwood, musk, amber. This is a very, very good amber perfume for women. You're gonna find also vanilla, you're gonna find rose, jasmine. I smell also rose jasmine for sure. I smell a little bit of ylang ylang. It's a beautiful amber perfume and you can also see the color, this beautiful amber color. This is a very, very good oriental. So the last family of perfume that French girls also like to wear, it's what we call chypre and green perfume. French girl, and I have some friends, they don't like, some French girl, they don't like sugary or sweet perfume. For example, I have one from Prada, for example, that is super, super sugary. I think it's the most sugary perfume, sweet perfume you can find out there. It's not really the French taste at all. There's too much sweet in it. And usually they don't find it super, super elegant. And I have a friend that she doesn't like floral perfume. She only like very, very green, woody perfume and chypre. Chypre perfume, they also combine different type of notes. You're gonna find green notes, woody notes, a little bit of liver also. And you're gonna find some flowers, but very, very green flowers, okay? So there's no sweetness in chypre perfume. And I have some very iconic perfume to show you. So the first one, it's a, I think it's the most iconic green perfume ever. First, because it's one of the first perfume created by Pierre Balmain. Pierre Balmain wanted also to launch his own perfume collection. And he decided, you know, it's very surprising, you know, he could have created a perfume with aldehyde. It was very trendy at that time, following like Coco Chanel, you know, trend. Could have also created a perfume with rose. No, he decided to create a perfume with only green, green notes. So there's no, absolutely no, a little bit of flower in the middle notes probably, but there's absolutely no sweetness in this perfume. It's really, if I have to describe this perfume, which was also the favorite perfume of Colette, you know, the French writers. Yeah, just to try it. Yeah, it's like, you know, if I have to describe this perfume, it's that you're just taking some herbs, you know, herbs on your hands, fresh herbs. It's a very, very fresh perfume, and I find some woody notes on the base, but the first opening notes, they're super, super, super fresh, okay? It's very, very intense. It's a very intense green green perfume. So usually in green perfume like that, you're gonna find a lot of vetiver, musk, amber, lemon, bergamot notes, sometimes some flowers, but maybe more white. For example, in this one, in the middle notes, you're gonna find some lily of the valley, but it's a very, very subtle because the opening notes are very fresh and more green, you know, than flowery. Another one, which was also my signature for years, and it's a very green, very, very green perfume. It's, so unfortunately, you're not gonna find, you know, you're not, there's no inscription anymore, but this is Jean-Louis Scherrer by Jean-Louis Scherrer. So it's also more a niche perfume that you can find online, but it's a very interesting chypre, if I spray a little bit. So there's no lemon, bergamot, but this is gonna find a lot of vetiver in this one, musk, cedar, sandalwood, amber. So this one is more a chypre perfume than a green, you know, very green. but it's a very, very, you know, elegant chypre, and I really like the style of this perfume. It's very unique. If you want to check other green perfume that's very, very sophisticated and elegant, you can check also 19 by Chanel, Crystal, you know, Eau de Crystal, which is a very, very good green perfume, which I love to wear during the summer, for example. You can check Eden by Cacherel, for example. You can also check Fiji. And also check Nina Ricci, Bella, also the collection of Jardin sur le Nil by Hermès, a very, very good green, aromatic also perfume. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and you master now what type of perfume French women wear. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also to leave a comment, you know, what type of perfume do you like, what type of perfume you don't like, if there is one signature perfume. I hope to see you soon for another video. Bye.